having something, and if you are going to die, that is not the end. That's what I told. Seers of the person, those who can see before your existence, and those who can see even after your absence. Those who can see before your existence and after your absence, they are known as seers. Likewise, the karmic theory says that you have to live your principal life. If you are suffering, that is your previous cause. And if you are doing good, don't worry, it will be going to benefit you at your later time or your generation. So, your moral way of life, and for discovering the mysteries of the world, the karmic theory, which has created the creation, evolution, justification of goodness and evilness in the order, everything is governed only by the karmic theory. That is the contribution of only our country. And the third thing is multi-level knowledge systems. We have epistemology, knowledge-oriented things. Metaphysics, science about something which is indriyadita, that which is beyond the senses, indriyadita. That is known as metaphysics. We are having ontology, that is Adhyatma Mula Shastra, eschatology, that is Murti Shastra, that which happens after death. We are having epistemology, agathology, science of goodness and sin. We are having aritology, we are having thaumatology, we are having teleology, we are having geritism. We are having innumerable systems of knowledge, which when we are discussing these systems in a great advanced way of life, the whole society was uncivilized, nomadic and nude. So we are having such a rich treasure, and that must be re-implanted. Now we are coming to the stage of life in which I want to say some great things. First of all, you must understand there are five R's. One is routinal life. One is routine, what we call routine. And second thing is reward. That is the benefit of some of our activities, the fruits of our activities. It is known as like that. Third thing is recreation. Some way for soothing our mind. The fourth thing is retrogression. The unwanted things that intrude into your mind or physical body, that gives retrogression. The fifth thing is replantation or replenishment. That replenishment is also offered by the Vedas. So all these five things are controlled by our spiritual principles. Even taking bath, brushing your teeth are with mantras. What is science and what is spiritualism? That which sees even a mega event without any base is science. That which sees even a small notion and activity of human being with a great cause is known as spiritualism. You are brushing your teeth and you are thinking, just we are brushing our teeth. It is teeth and it is a brush and it is a paste, nothing like that. So, Shastra says that there are innumerable devatas, energy or force implantations here. By qualifying those things for vak siddhi, for mantra, for gana, for uchharana, for bhasha patana, for kavitva rachana, innumerable things are inside. So, they worship vanaspati and they worship saraswati and they do that. So, everything is magnified. In spiritualism, does that even the routinal activities are considered to be divine services. Taking bath and going to saucha and doing small things which are just human instinctive and natural, very casual in the society, they are considered with great divine significance. So routinal activities are also divine. Reward activities like your occupation, rewarding activities like your occupation, business, everything, that is also considered to be divine. Recreative activities like literature, art forms, like music, like painting and drawing, then dance, then sculpture, everything was divine. Either God connected, godly, God represented, or divine strictly in nature. So our routine was God, and our recreation was God, and our reward was God. If we get retrogression, that is also due to God, because of not remembering Him. That's why great people told, there is only one sampatti to human being, and only one vipat. To get the necessary thing is sampat. To get the necessary thing, and not to get the unnecessary is sampat. To get something unnecessary and lose something that is necessary is known as vipat. And great people, they told, Vishnor Vismaranam Vipat Sampan Narayana Smritihi. So the retrogression is because of lack of proper contact with the divinity, the divine origination. So replenishment, for getting it back, we want to get with God. That is the school of thought of India, by which the routinal, the reward giving, as well as the replenishing and retrogressive, as well as the recreative systems, even time passing events are connected with God. Now we are having three problems. Aho Ratra. Now it is night. For America, it is day. Likewise, we started with a very advanced civilization. Now we are in the night. And those people, they were nomadic tribes. And now they are in the daylight. They are in the progression of science, technology, richness. And they are teaching a lot of things to us. So it is known as Aho Ratra Nyaya. Second thing is Gomamsa Nyaya. I want to say that Gomamsa Nyaya. What is Gomamsa Nyaya? See, if a cat is eating a mouse, then there is nothing wondrous. Deterioration is common to everybody, like waxing and wearing of moon. Indians being deplorable and despicable, it is like cow eating mamsa. Our country, to its heritage and the wealth status of its spiritual splendor, this reiteration, this type of what we call debilitation, is something like cow is fed with mamsa. So anybody can be totally degraded. Degradation is the unavoidable component of birth. But Indians degrading is like a cow entangling into the process of something carnivorousness in nature. So Indians must be always a torchbearer and image model for this society. So you cannot say that the whole world is nonsensical, I am also nonsensical. Everybody is aberrant, I am also there. It is universal. We must not consider it to be universal. Because we were different and we are different. So we have to be different. That is the nature of our country. The third thing is parampara nyaya. How we can get this benefit? Somebody may ask the question. How we can have the benefit? We were having parampara. Now we are in the status of declination. But our parampara was in the state of substandard settlement and superstandard settlement and standard settlement. Now only we are in this level. But before thousands of years, before millions of years, our elders were there who were greater in valor, greater in knowledge, greater in tapasya, austerity and penance, greater in realization and transmission. So we have got a parampara. Do the Western community get any parampara? To the Western community, now existing community, can you say that they have a parampara? They don't have any parampara. They are in the process of ascending order, coming from a system of nomadism. They are coming towards civilization. Whereas we were well civilized and we are in the status of cultural invasion and cultural debilitation. Now we are in the process of degradation. So what is the great benefit for us? We are having a parampara. The problem is we don't have a link with the parampara. We are having pitrarjita vastu. And Svayarjita is very limited. We are having Pitrarjita, which is very much augmented, which is collected, augmented, and extravagantly stored for our purpose and development by great rishis like Vaivasvata Swayambhuva, Atri Vishnu, Briddhaharita, Angira, Atharva, Apastamba Bodhayana, Ranayaniya, Drakhyayaniya, Latyayaniya, Brihaspati, Parasara, Vyasa, Shakti, Shankalikita, Daksha, Gautama, Shatatapa, Prugu, Pulastya, Kanva, innumerable these seers, they have got the treasury of knowledge and we are having the parampara. Only thing is, we have to link with the main source. We are having 10,000 watts, they are having 2.5 watts battery, but they are linked due to which the torch is bearing. We are having a very big effulgence, but not linked with the power station. Our power station is the teachings of our ancestors, the lifetimes of our ancestors, the thoughts, the smriti and pujana. Thinking and worship, I have already told in a seminar, there are two forces or two methodologies. There are visible energies and invisible energy. How to get the visible energy? You have to work. How to get invisible energy? You have to worship. So work is the process to get visible energy. For example, if you have 5 acres of land, you must not go there and daily worship without doing any work. And in divinity, worship is the tool. And in materialism, work is the tool. So unite your work in materialism and worship in spiritualism. Relink yourself with the great effulgence of that multipotential transmitter of the divine radiation of the teachings, the lives and greatness of the people. Think them, worship them, imitate them, instill their ideas, inculcate in the modern society to your beloved people, your lovers, your followers and the other corresponding societies of memory, and also to create a very great drastic change in the society, a small spark that must be made and the area must be made combustible and the spark must result in a very blazing fire, totally eradicating the cloudy, murky sheets of India, reinstilling their glory, reinstilling the luminosity of knowledge and potency, once again rethroning India as a global leader. Narayan, Narayan, Narayan.
Thank you, Swamiji, for your highly enlightened lecture on India's. Very grateful to you, Swamiji. And now it is time for us to give our Swamiji a standing ovation for his excellent speech. Thank you. Now it is getting late.